I'm not a scientist and I'm not a doctor. I'm a 60-year-old woman with metastatic breast cancer. My prognosis is no better today than it would have been 40 years ago. This is unforgivable.
Let's talk for a moment about Laura Ziskin, who was a wonderful person. She called you before you won a Pulitzer Prize, and she said, I want to buy the rights to your book.
It was a pre-bound copy, and I have no idea how it landed up in Laura's desk, but she told me she read it cover to cover through the course of 2 nights. And the next morning, she was on the phone with me and said, you've got to come meet me because I have an idea about this book.
I describe myself, as everybody with cancer would, as an impatient patient. You know, I know that this disease is going to kill me if something better doesn't come along. I'm mad as hell. I want better treatments. You know, I want answers to my disease, and I believe the answers are out there. I wanted to use the bully pulpit of the media, which is where I live and work. I wanted to make a documentary.
She bought the rights, and then, of course, Stand Up to Cancer helped raise the funds. And her spirit really is very much in this documentary.
It was just born of that kind of ferocity that she had, that we have to do this. We have to get what Sid has put in this gem of a book out in a visual form. We're just sorry that we can't, you know, walk into a screening room today and say, hey, Laura, here's what we've done.
We're trying to do no less than change the culture of how scientific research is done.
What do you think Laura would have to say about the finished product, Sid?
I think she would be very moved by it. I think she would speak to her very directly. It would speak to her as a patient. It would speak to her as an advocate. It would speak to her sort of scientific brain. It would speak to her as a producer. I mean, you know, Laura encapsulated all of those things.
The issues of cancer are extraordinarily complex, medically, socially, and politically. But so what? Like the trip to the moon or the Manhattan Project, it starts with the will and the vision and the leadership to do it. We must act up.
We have to be problem solvers. That's the only way we're going to change the world. We have to think outside. We have to look outside.